Punahou art teacher Bob McWilliams is the creator of ceramic implements for the Japanese tea ceremony known as Chanoyu. Punavision spoke to Mr. McWilliams about his craft and this tradition.
My background in ceramics is kind of interesting because I never went to college in ceramics. I came to Hawaii in 1976 and just said I'm going to be a studio potter, meaning just get a studio, a little place to work, and become a potter and make that my living. Teach mostly wheel one, and that's an introduction to ceramics on the potter's wheel, mostly getting students used to the potter's wheel and getting a little historical background in clay, a little technical background in clay, a little aesthetic background in what good pottery is. Wheel two I also teach, which is an extension the second semester after wheel one, which explores much more about different projects mostly. It's much more project oriented. Students do lidded jars, learn how to make lids, make teapots, do a reproduction of a ceramic artist, things like that, and then an independent project, and do glaze experiments and explore aesthetics more. Now I also teach sculpture this year, which not only involves clay, but other mediums such as plaster, plasticine, wire, natural fibers, what else? Found objects, different things like that. And then I also teach handling, ceramic handling, which I'll teach next semester. And that comes around every once in a while.
Okay. I like black and white.
And that's much more restricted to just hand-built sculptural pieces, slab-built, coil-built, pinch pots, as well as all the firing involved and glazes and decoration. And it's very involved. It's very complicated and never-ending, which is fun. Keeps you interested all the time. The first time I ever saw any ceramics made on a potter's wheel was in college. A friend of mine had a piece of pottery on his dining table, and I asked him where he bought it, and he said he made it. And I was amazed that he could make something like that. I get influence from looking at other people's work in other media, such as work in glasswork, looking at the form and the shape and the color sometimes, although most of the time, I'm mostly interested in the shape. The color, the glaze, the decoration is not something I'm really that interested in. So I'll pick up shapes from everywhere, from metalwork, woodworking craft, glasswork, anything that I can see that kind of influences that. Or I'll see another piece of pottery also. Throwing comes fairly natural to me, and I feel real comfortable throwing. Glazing is much more complicated, but also in the same sense much more loose, in that once you put it in the kiln to fire the pieces, in a sense the kiln takes over. I mean, you have a certain amount of control over the firing and the temperature at which you fire at and the way you make the glazes, but you lose a little control, which makes it a little more of a chance occurrence of what happens in the kiln. And a lot of those are great, but some of those are not so great. And so you get good T-bowls or you get good pieces and you get ones that don't come out very well, or they run and it'll end up in a pool on the kiln shelf or things. So I think glazing and decorating for me is really difficult, much more difficult, and I'm not that interested in that part either. I'm much more, as I said before, interested in the form and what it looks like and how it feels. So, the art show, the Chanoyu ceramic implements for tea, the Japanese tea ceremony, is a show at Line Kona, and we've been that group of potters. There's about five of us that have been together for about 15 years doing implements for tea, mostly tea bowls, but other things too. And I made ceramic pedestals and then put tea bowls on those that really didn't have any other way to stand up. The bottoms are pointed or rounded, and those are real different for me. Kind of with the idea that once you pick it up, you really can only set it down back on the pedestal. You can't set it on the table or the tatami mat. And the other couple that were really interesting for me this year were some that were carved to make it look like it was wood. Kind of a Trump loyal thing that fools your eye. You think it's, from a distance, you think it looks like wood, but when you get up close, you can tell it's ceramic. And one small tea bowl can be really a metaphor for so much. I mean, everything, every little nuance in the tea bowl. And I've never made two that are alike in 25 years. So it makes it interesting, and it keeps me interested in it too.